Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2709. This morning, a new thing called Agent Mode debuts. It just leapfrogs over Start with Copilot. Just noting that today is September 29th, 2025. Excel was released on September 30th, 1985. It feels to me like someone said we need to do something amazing before the 40th birthday, because this is 39 years, 364 days. For this thing to get released. Here is the blog post about it. It is an amazing way to create a workbook from scratch. Currently, it is only running in Excel Online and only running from Excel Labs. The first thing I'm going to note is just how long this thing actually thinks. I mean, it's taking like 5 to 10 minutes to build this workbook, and with a lot of thought that seems to be going into it, assumptions, rework on his part. So my second attempt here is build a tracker for supernatural fitness, one row for each day in October. There should be columns for total minutes, total points, boxing minutes, and flow minutes, and calorie burn. Add conditional formatting to highlight the highest number in each column. Include columns for running total points and running total calories. I know that when Start with Copilot would use a table, it could not get the running totals correct, so I threw that in. Because, you know, let's test it and see if it's gotten any better. Off to the side, add a chart showing weekly progress on points and minutes. That means that these daily days have to be converted to weeks. And never merge cells. Use center across a selection instead, which seems like a very weird thing to ask for. But I have to tell you, in the first one I created, they merge cells, right? First impression, and you're merging cells, and they even bragged about it, that they merged cells to make it look better. Yeah, right here in the report, what I built, they have cell A1 merged across A1 to F1 with the title with a dark blue header. No, never merge cells. So that's why in this one, I said to use center across a selection. And what's funny is as I was watching this work, at first that cell was merged and stayed merged through 98% of the process and got changed to center by selection at the end. I'm very interested in their notes here, because their notes are talking about how they're essentially using OfficeScript.js. Yeah, here we go. Notes and small fixes made. I initially tried applying certain formats via an incorrect property path. This .format.fill and .top.bottom.format.fill. That seems to be OfficeScript, which is interesting that they're using that in the background. Of course, VBA doesn't work in Excel Online, so that makes sense. To comply with my never merge requirement, they made sure to use center across selection, which is great that they figured out how to do it. You know, here's the data for this chart with that heading of week, and that forced these numbers to be actually be the first series. So we have three series being plotted here. I remember this. I got burned by this 30 years ago and learned that that cell has to be blank before you create the chart. Here we are. This is brand new. It's like, you know, it's the first week that it's been creating spreadsheets, maybe. Easy mistake. When they initially created this, the dates on the left-hand side were text. And I said to them, the dates you entered in column A are not Excel dates, they're text. This is causing value errors in the week column. And it reasoned for 161 seconds. That's forever. You're right. The values in column A were being treated as text, which is why the weak formula produced value. They had made things that looked like a date and time zone, right? So it shows the formula it's going to use to calculate the week. It verifies that it's working. There is a lot of explanation over here that is going into this. This is completely different than Start with Copilot, which, by the way, disappeared a few weeks ago, and I can't get anyone in the Excel team to verify that it's really gone forever. But now that we see this, it seems that Start with Copilot is probably really gone forever, because this is running circles around it. It would be interesting to do a new video, just start from scratch, type the prompt, and just let it run. And you can all see how long it takes to create this. Microsoft's obvious advantage here is that if they're running inside of Excel, then, you know, being able to write to the Excel grid, that seems to be a key differentiator between, let's say, ChatGPT, that's at best is going to create an Excel file and let you download it, and then you open it in Excel. To actually watch this thing get created and see the conversation on the right-hand side, It seems to be just a massive leap forward from where we were yesterday. I'll put this blog post down in the YouTube description that explains how to get it and what you need to do and how to install Excel Labs in Excel Online and the whole bit. Give it a try. It's pretty cool. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.